Hey guys, welcome back to Comic-Gen TV, the only place on YouTube where all geek culture collides. If you're new to the channel, welcome. Don't forget to subscribe and click on the notification bell so you don't miss out on a single video. Before we get started on today's video, I want to announce that Comic-Gen has two new channels for you guys to enjoy. If you're into collectible and toy reviews, then head on over to Comic-Gen Collectibles, where all of our new and previously uploaded collectible review videos will be published from now on. Also, if you're into Funko Pops and action vinyls, head on over to Comic-Gen Vinyls, where all new and previously uploaded pop review videos will be uploaded. We will no longer be publishing these videos onto the main channel, due to the success of our shows like History and Origins. We don't want to upset the algorithm or the subscribers, so if that's what you're interested in, the links will be in the description below. Now on to our video. Space Ghost Coast to Coast was created by Mike Lazow and hosted by the 1960s Hanna-Barbera cartoon character Space Ghost, as a reboot of the series intended for adults, reinterpreted as a surreal spoof talk show and produced using the original artwork from the 1960s Hanna-Barbera series. The first two seasons were presented as a serious talk show with subdued jokes, while the later seasons relied more on surrealism, non sequitur, and tabloids. Coast to Coast premiered on April 15, 1994 and ran until December 17, 1999. The series was revived on May 7, 2001 and was moved to the new Adult Swim late night programming block on September 2nd of that year, where new episodes premiered until April 12, 2004 on Cartoon Network's Adult Swim. The series spun off two separate shows during its time, that of Cartoon Planet and The Brack Show. Cartoon Planet was an animated variety show that originally ran from 1995 to 1998 and 2012 to 2014 on Cartoon Network, which began as an hour-long block of cartoons hosted by Space Ghost, Zorak, and Brack, where they would introduce full cartoons from the Turner Entertainment Library, such as old theatrical shorts and Hanna-Barbera cartoons, including the original 1960s Space Ghost episodes. Whereas The Brack Show was an animated sitcom, which originally aired prior to the official launch of Adult Swim on Cartoon Network on December 21st, 2000, and ended on December 31st, 2003, and later on May 24th, 2007, a webisode for the series was released on Adult Swim Video, ending the series. Over Coast to Coast time on the air, various celebrities appeared on the show in a pre-recorded format to make it seem that Space Ghost and the guests were having a conversation. Space Ghost's interactions with guests were almost always painfully awkward and sometimes hostile. It was sometimes hard to tell if the guests were aware of the nature of the program on which they were appearing. Their answers often did not match the questions coming from Space Ghost, because the questions were changed after the interview. This method was dropped in later episodes, and the guests were allowed to directly interact with the characters. The other members of Coast to Coast consisted of his enemies from the 1960s animated series, such as the evil Zorak, and his director-producer, the red-helmeted lava man named Moltar, who worked for Space Ghost as punishment for their crimes. Space Ghost, the announcer, a salesman, and various other characters were voiced by George Lowe. Zorak and Moltar were voiced by C. Martin Croker. Brack and Lokar were voiced by Andy Merrill, with guest appearances by Harvey Birdman, another former Hanna-Barbera superhero who in-universe became an attorney at law voiced by Scott Fennell. Alex Toth, the original creator of the Hanna-Barbera cartoon, was rumored to have not been pleased with the parodical usage of his characters, but through written letters, this rumor was disproven, with Toth admitting he appreciated all adaptations of his work. Due to the popularity of the show and the characters, four rocks found on the planet Mars were named after Space Ghost, Zorak, Moltar, and Brack. In January 2009, IGN named Space Ghost Coast to Coast as their 37th favorite animated TV show in their Top 100 Best Animated TV Shows article. And in 2013, IGN placed Space Ghost Coast to Coast as number 18 on their list of top 25 animated series for adults. Space Ghost, whose real name is Tad Eustace Ghostel, and I overpronounced that because in the last video, a lot of people claimed that I said Ted rather than Tad, so Tad Ghostel, was occasionally conflicted about whether saving the world or hosting a talk show best suited him. Tad genuinely wanted to put on the best talk show he could. Unfortunately, his failings tended to get the better of him. As he was shown to be childish, egotistical, and petty, he also remained generally oblivious to his surroundings. During the series, Space Ghost had little regard for the well-being of others, and often demeaned his sidekicks and guests. In an interview with Conan O'Brien, Space Ghost announced that he had always been dead and was never a spaceman. "I was dead long before you were born, Conan, and I'll be dead long before you're dead." Space Ghost appears in almost every episode, with the exception of the episodes Pilot and Hipster, both from seasons 4.
Zorak Roberts, as stated earlier, was the band leader and a mantis-like alien known for his hatred of Space Ghost. Being extremely evil, he once ate his own nephew. It was stated on the show that he's a virgin, largely due to the fact that he does not wish to be eaten by his mate after intercourse, which is normal for mantises. He has no remorse, feels no pity, and acts only to meet his own ends. He was Brack's childhood friend, and his superhero persona is Batmantis. Though Space Ghost's prisoner, Zorak retains his membership in the Council of Doom and claims he is either a locust or a mantis, but he often changes his mind. Moltar was the show's director and producer. His body was made entirely of lava, because of which he normally wore an orange and gray full-body containment suit, which had a breathing receptacle. By far the most competent and level-headed character, Moltar sometimes tended to be smarter than he seemed, and appeared to be very good friends with Zorak, even though Zorak didn't have the same feelings for him. Moltar was a big fan of Chips and its star Eric Estrada, and made a brief appearance in Cartoon Planet where he, Zorak, and Breck got into a fight until Space Ghost sent him and Zorak to their rooms. Moltar would later become the fictional producer for Cartoon Network's action animated block Toonami in 1997, before being replaced by Tom in 1999. Breck was a cat-like teenage alien with large fangs who, although a villain, was the least threatening one on the program. Appearing on Coast to Coast periodically, Breck was often with the Council of Doom, of which he was a member, and often victimized by Space Ghost or the other villains. Brack hijacked Coast to Coast once in the episode Jerk, wanting the audience to hail him, doing the intro and even the music much to Ghost's embarrassment. He also co-hosted Cartoon Planet and went on to host his own series with Zorak. Harvey Birdman was the host of Coast to Coast in the episodes Pilot and Sequel, and also appeared on the sidelines during two other episodes, which he appeared to be a washed-up superhero and in a rut, alternately claiming to be unemployed, after which he got a job as a lawyer in his own spin-off show, Harvey Birdman, Attorney at Law. Space Ghost's last on-screen appearance was on October 14, 2011, in the Batman the Brave and the Bold episode, Bold Beginnings.
If you enjoyed that video, make sure you hit the subscribe button right there so you stay up to date on all things geek culture. Also, go ahead and check out one of these two playlists on the side for more videos just like the one you just watched. I'm Shannon from Comic Getting TV, the only place on YouTube where all geek culture collides. Take care, geeks.